So good afternoon and welcome to our organ concert. I was happy to hear that some of you are here because you said you cannot find organ concerts that easily in the area. So we're happy to oblige. And those of you who are familiar with our parish and know Bill Wisnom very well, since he's our organist, and we're very privileged to have him play every Sunday for us. He will introduce all the pieces, I believe.
Yeah.
Yes. We wanted to wait. We have, for those who want to welcome those who are watching us using the live stream, those who do not feel comfortable yet coming out in person watching. But things are improving, and we're really happy about that. Feeling like the concert series is slowly being able to bring back more concert goers. So thank you for being here, and please welcome Bill Wisnom.
Do you mind if I take this off? In 1932, Marcel Dupré, who was one of the premier organists and composers of the 20th century, was giving a recital at Wanamaker in Philadelphia. And those of you who are familiar with Wanamaker's knows that there's a huge organ there. He was improvising, and he got the idea for a piece based on this improvisation entitled The World Awaiting the Savior. And he compiled different movements depicting the life of Christ. This first movement, there are two things going on. First, it is the freneticism of humanity before the arrival of Christ. And then there is the chant, Jesu Redemptor Omnium, Jesus Savior of us all, that comes in the middle of the piece. And then the two themes come together, which symbolizes the unity of humanity and Christ, for a triumphant ending.
Thank you.
The next piece is by Dietrich Buxtehude. However, Buxtehude could not make it this evening. So instead, we're going to have a Noël by Louis-Claude Decamps. Decamps was a Parisian organist, and he was very popular. And he played basically pop music in church. Didn't really go over too well with the clergy. Christmas Eve, he would premiere all the new Noëls for the season. People would come out for midnight mass, they would stay for the prelude, and then when mass would begin, everybody went home. So the archbishop decreed that there would be no more Noëls. That ban has since been lifted. And so this is Noël number 10.
Thank you.
next piece, Soliloquy by David Conti, is a reflective piece that was written in 1996. David Conti is the head of the composition department at San Francisco Conservatory of Music. And the piece was written to honor Chick Holtkamp, who is an American organ builder. They had what was called a Chick Fest, where they celebrated his organs and the contribution he has made to the organ field. So this is Soliloquy. Sebastian Bach, of course, is one of the great composers of Western music and also one of the major figures of organ literature. The Prelude and Fugue in B minor was inspired by his time studying with Buxtehude, who you did not get to hear, in Lübeck, Germany. And while he was there, he was supposed to be there, I believe, for a few weeks to study with Buxtehude, but he was so enthralled with Buxtehude's work that he stayed for 3 months. And when he returned, his church, his boss, had him jailed for having spent too much time away from work. So this is the Prelude and Fugue in B minor. No one goes to jail anymore for church music, so.
Thank you.
César Franck was a Belgian composer in the 19th century and was known for composing in a way that was reflective of orchestral music. At the same time, there was an organ builder by the name of Aristide Cavaillé-Coll, who was building orchestral style instruments with the idea that you could project these symphonic works of symphonic nature. It was the biggest that organs had become at that time. This is his Prière, which means prayer. Many people have tried to analyze what it really means as a prayer. It starts very dark. It blossoms into brightness and then goes back. I will not try to interpret what Franck meant by that. I will leave that up to you. This is his Prière, Opus 20. Thank you.
Thank you.
Charles Marie Vidor, Charles, was the organist at Saint-Sulpice Peace in Paris. He was the organist for over 50 years, but because his name sounded German, they did not give him the title of titulaire, of the main organist of the church. So he served in the capacity as, there's not really even a contracted organist for the entirety of his life. This is his allegro from his sixth symphony. It's inspired by Spanish habanera. He was obsessed with Spain, and you can almost hear the toreadors in the middle section.
Thank you.
his brain can follow all those lines of music is just beyond me. And the feet. So thank you so much, Bill.
It's such a pleasure
to watch you play, more than just the regular hymns, which are also wonderful. So thank you so much for being with us this afternoon. We did not print postcards this year because we just didn't know how the year was going to go. But it looks like we're turning a corner, and it's nice to see so many of you this evening, because it's been hard to get back. But I did put all the dates for the following concerts on the sheet for tonight, for this afternoon. They're also on the website, but we have the next concert is soon. It's in 2 weeks, and it's our traditional Irish concert. This time we'll have Laura Byrne and the Celtic Corridor. They also dancers from the Teelin School of Irish Dance will be there. So it's always a treat to be at the Irish concerts. Please spread the word that we're back and that the Irish concert will be back. The following concert is on May 1st, and I'm really looking forward to that concert too. The Apollo Orchestra, they reached out to me asking if they could perform here. It will be, I'm quite sure, a chamber orchestra, but the cellist who will be there as part of the orchestra is Amit Palette, who is a wonderful, wonderful cellist. I know you were saying the same thing. He graduated from Baltimore, from Peabody. But so we have really good things coming up. Check that. We will always send an email before the concerts. And if you are not on our email list, please let me know. We appreciate your support financially also, because we cannot do it without you. There's even a little QR code this time that Amy, who was here, said it worked just fine. So if you put your camera on there, it will open the donate page on our website. But we appreciate all of that. Thanks again, Bill. I was wondering if some of you may have questions. Are you okay with that? About the instrument?
Yeah.
Or because it's such a... I learned so much from becoming your friend and learning how the instrument functions, being from the choral side of things, that I think it's interesting sometimes to find out more about what's so different about an organ, for those who wish.
Feel free to come up and for those
questions
who,
or...
There's no pressure, of course.
Yes. Do you memorize all the keys to hit, or do you have some sort of a sheet there to tell you how to play?
No, it's memory. Memorize.
Fantastic.
Yes, sir.
Where are the speakers?
They're right over there. And there are some here over the altar. I didn't use those. In the Decan Noel, I used one over there in the back. But mainly right over here.
So how do you transmit? How does it transmit it from there to all of the speakers?
I have no idea.
Do you have a transmitter? You must have a transmitter.
Some sort of technology. I'm not good with technology.
How many times do you have to play it before you've memorized it?
Every piece is different. The Franck, the Pria, was really difficult to memorize. Some of the, like the Decan, was not difficult. It's hard to say. Every piece is different.
Yeah. So during the year, besides playing hymns, do you play something before every service?
I try to. Sometimes it's an improvisation. Sometimes it's pieces that have been written out. So, yeah. Yes?
I just wanted to say, sometimes if I come here at the 4 o'clock Mass and hear you play afterwards, it just seems to complete the Mass to sit there for a few minutes and hear you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yes, sir. Since I was 17. That was 1997 when I started. You can do the math.
In the big chill, the first opening scenes, they play Rolling Stones. You can't always get what you want.
Uh-huh.
Did you ever try, you know, the modern music or the 20th century, and just how would that work in your repertoire? This is beautiful, right? It sounded like I heard oboe in the prayer.
You did, yes.
That's what it sounded like to me.
Yeah. I have, I grew up with a Hammond B3 at home, so that's what I practiced on, but I never played pop music. The closest I have ever come to playing pop music was William Bolcom wrote gospel preludes for organ, and they're kind of dissonant, but they also include gospel music in them, so yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, thank you all.
Question.
Yes?
What year was the organ developed? What year did it start?
It was when Richard Fitzgerald was here, and that would have been 2008, 2007?
Is that what you're asking? When this
organ? No, like in history, when did the organ actually
Oh. The first instrument that we know of was in Greece. It was called a hydraulis, and it's from 2000 BC, I think. It's been a long time. And it, the bellows were pumped with water and a little keyboard, so.
Okay. Thank you.
Uh-huh, thank you. Well, thank you all. I'm sorry we don't have order.
Just down the curiosity, what is that all about?
Yes, this is...